Malacañang is asking Congress to declare a national emergency and grant special powers to President Duterte to address the novel coronavirus. Now, among these powers are the power to temporarily take over or direct the operation of any privately owned public utility or business affected with public interest, including but not limited to hotels, public transportation, and telecommunications entities. Hotels will be used to house health workers or serve as quarantine centers or medical relief and aid distribution centers, while public transportation will ferry health, emergency, and frontline personnel. Takeover of telecommunication entities is intended to facilitate uninterrupted communication channels between the government and the public. Management of these businesses will remain with the owners, but the president or his representative will direct and supervise their operations, providing for a reasonable compensation for additional damage or costs incurred by the owner. The same bill will also empower the president to purchase goods like testing kits, lease properties, and construct temporary medical facilities without going through the rules on procurement, as well as require businesses to prioritize and accept contracts for materials and services in connection with the fight against COVID-19. The bill also has provisions to regulate public and private transportation and traffic, as well as the distribution and use of power, fuel, energy, and water to ensure adequate supply. If the bill is enacted, the president can cancel appropriated programs, projects, or activities to generate savings and to reallocate unused and unspent funds or funds allocated for discontinued projects to measures to address the COVID-19 emergency. The proposed bill goes as far as repealing laws, setting aside funds for specific or special projects which have remained unused so that the savings may be reallocated. Another provision gives the president the power to realign any appropriation in the 2020 General Appropriations Act in order to fund measures to meet the emergency. The bill also seeks to punish any violation of the laws or the rules, regulations, and directives of the national government with 2 months jail time and a fine between 10,000 to 1 million pesos. In a text message to ABS-CBN News, Soto confirmed receipt of the draft bill, although he clarified that nothing is final beyond the title of the bill. He earlier told Senate reporters that key Duterte cabinet officials and legislative leaders during a meeting Saturday agreed to pass a bill that will give the president the financial authority to realign funds available to address the COVID emergency crisis. The Senate will hold a special session to discuss the bill at 10 a.m. Monday. The House of Representatives is also expected to discuss a counterpart bill. The Philippine government has ramped up its response to the spread of the coronavirus disease 2019 by first placing Metro Manila under community quarantine and later on enhancing it to an enhanced community quarantine. The country recorded 73 new COVID cases today, bringing the total number to 380. Six more people died today, bringing the total deaths to 25.